What can be the better place to learn a metal casting process if not a foundry? Today we have came to the vital casting of 4GIDC Vadodara to see how the metal casting process takes place. Essentially, today we will be seeing how the sand casting process takes place and the steps of it. We know that there are 5 main steps which are included in a metal casting process. The first one being the pattern making, second is a mold and pour making, third is the pouring and the solidification, the fourth is a fettling, and the fifth is the inspection. So today, to begin with, pattern making is something which happens in the pattern shop. As we know that the patterns are made up of a different materials, it can be a wood, it can be a metal, it can be a polymer, it can be a plaster of Paris, it can be a frozen mercury, it can be wax. There are various materials from which the pattern can be made. Today we will be seeing the mold making of this particular casting. That if we want to produce a casting of this particular size and shape and this particular geometry, then how the mold is going to be prepared. So let us go and see that how the mold is made for this particular casting. So as we saw, now today we are going to see the molding of that particular component that we have earlier shown to you. This is the pattern to make the particular component. As I said that the pattern is made up of a various material. This particular metal is made up of a aluminium, and the mold has a two parts to it. One is a cope, another is a drag. So now the Machu Bhai is going to make the cope and drag both, and he is going to prepare the entire mold. And now let us look at how this particular process takes place. This is the molding sand. Molding sand is a mixture of a silica sand. It has a clay, it has a sodium silicate or water, and it has some amount of additives as well. But here they have not used the water, here they have used the sodium silicate. When you use sodium silicate, the sand is called as a dry sand. So with the help of a dry sand, the whole mold will be prepared. But when we, you can see this is a sand which they are adding. When we use a dry sand, in order to make a proper mold, we have to do CO2 molding. Which means that when the mold is prepared, we have to pass the CO2 gas into it. Why? Because the sodium silicate is going to react with the CO2, and it is going to make a silica gel. And silica gel acts as a good binder which holds the molding sand together. So now he is placing a pattern on, and after placing a pattern, he is pushing the pattern. Now you can see this is one type of a ramming or a compaction, where some mechanical force is applied so that the binding between the particles of a molding sand happens, and it remains together. Ramming is basically performed to increase the strength of a mold. So now, as we can see, the holes are created into this particular mold box, and now he is passing the CO2 gas. As I already explained you, that the CO2 is going to react with the sodium silicate and going to produce the silica gel. So this is what the CO2 molding is. This is how the CO2 molding is done. The CO2 gas has to be passed from the molding sand. Now he is applying a parting sand. A parting sand is applied so that the cope and drag are easily removed from each other, so that they don't stick to each other. That's why the parting sand is applied. And the junction where the cope and drag meets, that particular line is called as a parting line. He has prepared the drag part of a mold, and now he is going to prepare the cope part of it. In order to do that, he is going to add the sand to it. Again, he is going to do the ramming. But as we know that in a metal casting process, the shrinkage takes place. And in order to compensate the liquid shrinkage, the riser is placed. So now this particular cylindrical part that you see here, it is going to create a cylindrical cavity here. And that cylindrical cavity is going to act as a riser. A Again, the sand is added so that he can prepare the coat. This sand is brought from the muller. Muller is a equipment which is used to mix the sodium silicate, silica sand, clay, and if there are any other additives, if they want to add. So from muller they are bringing this particular sand. In this particular foundry there were two mullers. One is a conventional muller, which is a very much like a mixture that we use in a kitchen, and another is a hydraulic muller. We'll see that hydraulic muller later on. It's a time to remove the pattern. So now he is going to remove the pattern from it. Raju bhai. So as we can see here, once he removes the pattern and again places the coke onto the drag, the mold will be ready. The only part left after that is to pour this particular mold and solidify the metal, and then to bring the casting out by breaking the mold. Because this is a small casting, this casting does not have a separate riser. Here the liquid metal will be poured through the sprue in order to create a passage so that the liquid metal can enter into this particular cavity. He is removing the sand and he is making a space so that the liquid metal can flow into the cavity. Now he is going to place the coke onto the drag and then the mold will be ready. And after that, this mold will be taken for the pouring process. Thanks a lot, Baju bhai. So this is a very popular and very popular old conventional muller. This muller is used to mix the silica sand with the clay, with the sodium silicate and additives. There is one more muller So this one is a hydraulic muller. It operates on a, you know, principles of a hydraulics. On this overhead tank, what we have is a sand, and in this particular tank, what we have is a sodium silicate. And this pipe takes the sodium silicate to this particular chamber, and from the overhead chamber, the sand is going to come, and both of them will be mixed here. And once the mixing has taken place, from this particular outlet here, the mixture is going to come out. So here the mixing has started, and the molding sand is coming out of the muller. And this particular sand then will be taken for the mold preparation. As you can see, this is the furnace, as I just explained. This is an induction furnace in which the liquid metal is prepared. There is a crucible in it. The liquid metal will be transferred to ladle, and through a ladle, the metal will be poured into the mold. So now let us look at the pouring process. Now what we are going to see is a pouring process. So in order to pour the liquid metal, the liquid metal has to be prepared. So we have a lump of a solid metal which is kept into the furnace, and furnace is going to heat the lump of a solid metal which will be later on converted to the liquid metal. In order to convert the solid into the liquid, the metal has to be heated above its melting point temperature. We are going to see the pouring of this particular mold. As we know that the mold has a two parts, one is a cope, one is a drag. The upper part, as you can see, this one is called as a cope, and the lower part is called as a drag. And if you want to see the cope and drag separately, then as you can see, that particular component where I have pointed my finger, that's the drag of this particular mold. And as you can see, this one is a cope of a particular mold. So what they want to make here is that they want to make a circular ring which is used in a cement industry. That's the product that they are going to make. You must be wondering that why there are so many weights which are kept onto the mold. It is because of the reason that once the pouring will take place, there is a lot of gases are going to evolve, and when the gases will evolve, it may push the cope in an upper direction, and the mold may fail. In order to prevent the failing of a mold, these many weights are kept. Now we will see there are two pouring basins which they have kept, which means that there are two places from where the mold will be poured, and there are total six risers, because the casting is so huge it requires more number of risers. This particular the mold has a six risers. Now I think the pouring process is going to begin anytime soon, so let us look at it. So here we can see there is an oxide layer, and with the help of this particular rod, they are holding the oxide layer so that it doesn't get into the liquid metal, it doesn't get into the mold, and the casting produced is of a sound and a good quality. Okay.
This effect is very good. The powder which helps to good temperature to riser.
Okay.
So the casting will be prepared hot while the riser is hot. So the shrinkage and all these effects will not come.
Correct.
Hence that they are adding again another metal in the riser.
So now this particular casting has a two pouring basin and a six risers, which means there are two places from where the metal will be poured and the six risers, as we know that, or probably we'll learn along as the subject will go on, that a riser is a reservoir of a liquid metal which is kept to compensate the liquid shrinkage which is taking place. As you can see, as my finger goes, that one is a pouring basin. On the other side, there is one more pouring basin. And here, this you can see there are six risers. One is here, second is there, third is over there, fourth is here, fifth is here, and sixth is here. So there are total six risers are there. And now, once this particular casting will be solidified, then this whole mold will be broken and the casting will be taken out. So after pouring and solidification, once the liquid metal which is there into the mold solidifies, it's a time comes to break the mold and taking the casting or the solidified part out. And in order to break the mold, we have one machine which is a vibrating mesh. When it vibrates, it is going to break the mold. The sand goes down, and what remains on the top is the two mold boxes and the solidified part, which is also called as a casting. And once the solidified part is collected from there, it is clean, because if there are some sand particles which are which has adhered to it, it will be clean for the sand, and then it will be taken for a post processing, which can be any machining process, which can be a grinding process, or if they want to create a small hole into it, so drilling process, or any turning process. So any kind of post processing process after performing the machining processes onto the solidified part or a casting, the finished product will be ready. Many times the finished product is sent for the heat treatment or for a sand blasting. So depending on what is application of application of that particular product or that particular component, the post processing will be, which post processing process needs to be done, will be decided on the basis of that. Over the years, the owner of Vital Cast, Ravi Bhai Joshi, has helped me in showing the practical aspects of a metal casting process to the students. And today also, when we came here, he was very welcoming, and I would like to thank him. Thank you, sir, for allowing us to take this video of a sand casting process. I would like to ask I would request Ravi Bhai to say a few words to the students who are going to learn the metal casting process.
Thank you very much, Ravi sir, also that he is also having a keen interest to teach the student, because it's a rare moment now the teachers are so keen to have a look in the foundry also, because it's a very risky process. Have you seen in the videos also? But I must say, the foundry is a subject that it is the mother of any mechanical industries. So anything can be produced from this foundry only. So we can say that the casting is a process name, and foundry is a total, the industry we can call is a foundry. So in this casting process, you must have seen the videos of sand casting. We are also manufacturing the investment casting, that you can see the molds behind me. These all are the investment casting molds, which are come from the wax mold patterns. That is also low loss products. We can have that video, that boilers and all equipments are there for the investment casting also. So we have the dual casting processes in our foundry. We can make the sand casting also, which is from the 25 years, and we have developed the investment casting also since 10 years, and nowadays we are also expanding for the same. So in Vadodara region, we are among two manufacturers for the investment casting. And basically we are manufacturing all industrial products only. We are not in the decorative products or any other local brands. We also export the castings through the other manufacturers. Those who manufacture their products, their machines, their valves, their equipment, for that we are supplying these our products. Basically, casting is such a nice process that every engineer should learn, because you will get the idea of any product. Once the engineer, you became an engineer, you should strike that everything, how can be it is possible, how can we can make this product, only hinge, this, that, all. Now the casting is such a process that you can, you know, reduce the time of manufacturing, you can reduce the machining aspect, you can reduce and you can manufacture number of items, number of products and quantity of the products in a small point. Because fabrication and all aspects are that, but casting is such a good process that you can have that even in aircraft, in navy, in other industries. There are so many casting parts you can see. You can see in the railways, lot of parts. You enter in the bogie, lot of parts are castings. You open the bonnet of the car, lot of investment casting parts you will find. You open the door of your car, there are the hinges and all. They are also made from the castings. Lojo couplings, trucks, these, that, so many parts. They are from the, even in brakes of even all the two-wheelers, four-wheelers, they are the from SGIN castings. So there are so many, metallurgy is also involved in the casting process. So it is a one very good thing that you can make a non-corrosive metals to avoid the corrosion and all problems in our industrial area. So it is a thank you to sir also that in a very short period they give you this type of information. It will be very useful to you in your future. You must deserve this, and thanks to your sir also. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, Ravi bhai, for allowing us again to shoot the video. And he has always helped over the years. I know him from last 5 years, and he has always helped us and helped me in explaining the casting process in a better way to the students. Ravi bhai, the owner of a Vital Cast, they are the leading manufacturers in the Vadodara region as far as the investment casting and the sand casting is concerned. We are again thankful to him. Thank you very much, sir.